Hey, welcome everyone. I'm not surprised at all that you guys have a lot of questions for me in regards to the newly introduced XTR Di2 Wireless. I called it an upgrade kit, and in this short video, I'm gonna give you a few more cool facts about the shifted derailleur and one more thing about the cranks. So let's get to it. And in quick rapid fire style, I'm gonna answer a couple of questions from you guys. Number one question was, how is the newly released shifter and derailleur any different than the SRAM upgrade kits? That's what I have there. This is a GX SRAM AXS kit that was released a few years back. And the simple answer is, there's no difference whatsoever between AXS first generation upgrade kits and the XTR Di2 shifter and derailleur that were just released. If anything, I wish that Shimano included something cool in the box. You can see here, even for the GX, you had that SRAM branded multi-tool, and you also have a coaster, and it also sends you to the App Store to download their AXS app for their AXS drivetrain. I mean, Shimano, e-tube, project, cycling, I mean, who came up with that name? Question number two. Are we gonna have the cable version of this? I got that quite a few times. Well, it's called XTR M9100. We've had it since 2018. This and this, they are interchangeable. You want wireless, you use the new Di2. You want wired or cables, you use the devices that we've had for 7 years now. Then we have the statement that this is a new, completely new drivetrain from Shimano. And I kind of refuse to say that, because the reality is drivetrains need one thing and one thing only to function, and that is the shifting technology. We've already had not one, but two from Shimano in the last 7 years. One is called Hyperglide Plus. That gives us low weight and fast shifting. It was built for racing. Fast forward to when Shimano launched Link Glide, it was over the pandemic, and Link Glide, that takes care of the longevity of drivetrains for e-bikes. So Link Glide, its shifting technology is thicker teeth on the cassette. It lasts longer. It's only 11 speed. Did you guys notice that in this Di2 release, we also have a Link Glide e-bike derailleur and a Hyperglide Plus e-bike derailleur? Shimano can't be any clearer about these new technologies. Would you agree? SRAM, with their release of T-Type in 2023, they just invented Link Glide. They don't have Hyperglide Plus. That's why Hyperglide Plus is gonna be faster, was meant for racing. T-Type equals Link Glide. It is durable, works for e-bikes, but it's slower. So does that answer your question? So we have a new wireless shifter, a new wireless derailleur, no more wires. This is the Di2 protocol that they've used with Deore 2 years ago, so even the protocol is not new. This bolts onto pretty much everything existing. That means chainrings, cassette. And that's because it uses Hyperglide Plus and a normal derailleur hanger. And here's the nitty-gritty details about the shifter itself. This is SWM9250, as you see here in the box. This is the bar clamp version. And just by removing that tiny bolt here at the top, no, you cannot remove that cover. So we may or may not have conversion kits between bar clamp and i-spec EV in the future. It's not clear to me as of right now. Two, this shifter is the only one they have in their portfolio, can be used with e-bikes and racing cross country if you want. The only thing they have though is here in the back, you see that little switch. XTR had a switch on the previous generation shifters as well, between 11 and 12 speed gears. This little switch pretty much limits physically those buttons from moving to that second click. And that is a physical limitation, so this will have nothing to do with the software. Talking about the adjustability of the shift paddles, I love the fact that you can change the angle for your thumb. However, in order to work with this, you're gonna need a multi-tool. What do I mean by that? Well, for this screw on the cap, you need a 2mm hex key. To loosen up the buttons to adjust the angle, you're gonna need a 3mm hex key. And to tighten this bar clamp to the handlebar, you're gonna need a 4mm, because that's what they use for their brakes. So again, multi-tool needed to work with this, and you're gonna need a tiny flat screwdriver, as you could see, to shift between one and two. You're also gonna need that to remove the battery cover. So loosen up that bolt, and as you lift it up, you can see the two CR32 batteries side by side. This is a sealed compartment. See what I mean, Shimano? Missed opportunity. Wouldn't be cool to have something like this in the box to help you with the installation. Anyway, you have any questions for me in regards to the shifter, let me know in the comments below, because I'm moving on to the derailleur. And question number one from quite a few of you was in regards to the jockey wheels, whether the new are interchangeable with the old mechanical derailleurs. And the simple answer is yes, these are the same size. They are 100% interchangeable, and that would make for a cool upgrade for, I guess, any of the mechanical drivetrain components of the past. Talking about this, I mentioned to you that the cage is 10 millimeters longer. You can clearly see it here. Now, if this derailleur was meant to use the same 10 to 51 tooth cassette, I don't think there's any good reason why you would put a longer cage. But what if Shimano designed this cage with wider range in mind? What if they're gonna take that 9-tooth cog from 945 and just come up with a different wider range cassette when they launch the XT? That's definitely something to keep an eye on. That would be pretty cool if we got something like a 9-53 tooth cassette. What do you guys think? I would love to hear. Now, more of you ask me about the battery itself. It's a lithium ion tiny battery. I called it the Cube, very similar to what SRAM provides to us. One is 23 grams, one is 24 grams. One is gonna last about 20-25 hours in operation. Shimano tells us that this is gonna last about 350 kilometers. Like, what the heck, man? Give me an idea of riding time. But anyway, that's what we have. If you were to order replacement batteries from Shimano, you can see the price and the box here. This is a BT DN320. As opposed to the SRAM T-Type, this is not a rebuildable device. So aside from replacing the cage components and the jockey wheels and maybe the battery cover, there's nothing else that you can fix on this. There's no more carbon use here on the cage itself. And when it comes to the features of the T-Type transmission, as the ability for the derailleur to rotate back when hit right here up front, and by the way, remember that's why this is built like a wedge to deflect from hits right here where the clutch used to be. Well, rotating back, that's a function of the derailleur hangers that this steel need. So there is value in having this attached to the frame. This is built to be stronger than any derailleur hanger that exists today. So you're gonna bend derailleur hangers with this. The advantage of the new Di2 is that this can be installed on any bike that you might have, whether it's 20 years old or not. And one other thing that T-Type transmission and even AXS, they bragged about, was the ability of the motor to come back or to push back the derailleur when it's hit from a side. Shimano calls this automatic impact recovery. And yes, it exists in here, just like it is on any of the AXS derailleurs of today. Remember that little bumper that we had here just for the chain not to slap onto your derailleur cage? Well, even though this is not made out of rubber anymore, it's still there and is this little plastic piece that looks like it's gonna deflect the chain, making sure that it doesn't hit it. So it keeps the drivetrain silent. From the other reviewers, you know that this might tend to slap around or bang around probably here on the stop of the derailleur hanger. That's because you don't have a clutch anymore. You just have a strong spring, and there is no cage lock like they have it with SRAM. So have fun putting wheels on and off on a bike that has this installed on. One last thing about derailleur and shifter, actually, it's gonna be the weight. Derailleur all by itself is 381 grams. You add that battery cover, 390, and that's pretty much the weight that they provided. But this won't function without the battery, so 413 grams for the derailleur. Bar clamp version of the shifter is 105 grams. I assume i-spec EV is about the same. For the group set, this will be 517 grams altogether. Alternatively, you can have the full mechanical. Here's the derailleur, 243. Here's a shifter to go along with it, 376. Okay, you're gonna need housing. That's your 416 grams.
So simply from a weight perspective, would you prefer this or that? Would you give away 100 grams just to have wireless? I would love to hear in the comments. And I promised you that I'm gonna give you one more thing about the cranks themselves. You see this big mama logo right here on the crank arm? Well, pretty much all reviewers got this. And if you ask me, it kind of looks too big, it's flashy. It's pretty much what SRAM did with XO on their Enduro cranks. Remember the big XO in bold letters and colors? Well, if you look on their website, you're gonna see that there is the XC version of this. So 9200 does not have that big mama XTR on it. So what is your guys' preference? Big XTR logo here on the crank or not? Let me know in the comments below. And one more bonus question. What about that chain line, 55 millimeter chain ring being pushed out another 3 millimeters? Well, two things. One, if you use the old chain rings, you don't have 55, you have 52. And yes, the chain line will be more extreme when the chain is on the largest cogs. So that's 44 and 51 tooth cogs. So that's it, guys, is the second video that I do on this XTR group set. I hope you guys found it useful. Do you have any questions? Let me know below. Looking forward to the day when I can probably test some of this stuff. Looking forward to getting my hands on the new brakes. Are you excited about this? Let me know. Let me know if you liked the video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And until next time, see you folks on the trails. Cheers, guys. Cheers.